With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello students, in this question we have given that t is greater than equal to 0 and our s equal to x minus t whole square plus y square less than equal to t square, where t is t minus greatest integer function of t. And we need to check which of the following option is incorrect. So basically we have given that s is x minus t whole square plus y square less than equal to t square. So from here we can write as s is basically x minus t whole square plus y minus 0 whole square is less than equal to t square. Now we can easily see that this is the equation of circle. This is the equation of circle with center, with center is t comma 0 and radius is equal to t. Now in the question it says that t equal to t minus greatest integer function of t, where t is greater than equal to 0. So from here we can write as t equal to fraction part of x, and we know that fractional part of x is lie between 0 to 1. So from here we can write as t is lie between 0 to 1. So from here we can conclude that our radius lie between 0 to 1. So from here we can write as area of circle is basically when t is equal to 0, when we can say that pi multiply 0 square. So from here we can say that 0. And when t is less than 1, so basically area of circle we can say that pi multiply 1 whole square, this equal to pi. So from here we can say that area of circle, and circle is basically denoted by s, so we can write area of s is lie between 0 to pi. Basically 1 is not included, that's why pi is not included. So this is our first, so we can say that from option number 3 is correct. Now in the question, option number 1 say that the point 0 comma 0 does not belong to s. So basically we have center t comma 0. Now and we prove that t lie between 0 to 1. So from here when t equal to 0, so we can say that t equal to 0. So from here we can say that there is possible case when t equal to 0. So from here we can say that center of circle is 0 comma 0. This is possible, and option number 1 say that this does not belong to. So from here we can say that this option is incorrect. Now we have to check for option number 4. So option number 4 say that center s at any point t is on the line y equal to x. So basically we know that for t belongs to 0 to 1, when t equal to 0, our line y equal to x satisfy the equation of circle. Basically at center there is no intercept, but for t greater than 0, equation of line basically equal to y equal to x plus c. Basically here c is intercept, and which is anything. So from here we can't say that our center of s at any point is equal to y equal to x. So basically this option is also false. Now we have to check for option number 2. Option number 2 say that s is contained in the first quadrant for all t greater than 5. So from here we can say that when, let's suppose t is equal to 6.5, because in the question it says that t is greater than 5. Now our equation of circle is x minus t whole square plus y minus 0 whole square less than equal to t square. So basically here t equal to t minus greatest integer function of t, and this equal to fractional part of x. So from here we can write as t equal to fractional part of x, basically this equal to 0.5 and this equal to 1/2. So from here we can write as equation of circle, basically s is x minus 1/2 whole a square plus y minus 0 whole a square is less than equal to 1/2 whole a square. Now when we draw the equation of this circle, our circle, the diagram of our circle is like this, and here this is 1/2, 0 and its radius is basically 1/2, and we can easily see that for t greater than 5 our circle is also lie in fourth quadrant, and in the question it said that our circle only lie in first quadrant, so this statement is false. So from here we can say that option number A, B and D is correct. Basically we have to find incorrect question. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.